Good evening, sports fans, and welcome to Pinckney High School, and welcome. Football season is back. Tonight, an interesting contest and an old and a new rivalry. Pinckney and South Lyon will start their last years in the KLAA conference here tonight, and will move on to their new conference next year, continuing an SEC rivalry in the SEC conference, a KVC rivalry at the end of that, and a KLAA rivalry as well. We should be in for a great night tonight. Temperature out here is 80 degrees and sunshine. There is some scattered showers in the area. Hopefully we will get lucky and stick around. We should be in for a great one here tonight. It is October 25th, 2016, and we're back with the start of the 2016 football season for the South Lyon Lions here in a moment. Kicking off for the Pinckney Pirates, number 30, Riley Alexander, and deep to return for the Lions, number 6, Michael Maher. Kick will go into the end zone for a touchback. Make a mental note of that one, Boyer. The kid can kick, so we might, if we see some field goals later. Lions will start first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. Still 12 minutes to play in this first quarter. And you really couldn't draw up much better weather for this one here tonight. South Lyon in the road whites. If you notice the helmets a little different, they are this season. A new Lion logo, and each individual player's number will be on the opposite side of the Lion logo. Pinckney in the all black and the Jolly Roger on their helmet as well. Carry around the outside there, looks like number 24, Will Kelly, on the carry for South Lyon.
Kelly, the ball carrier for South Lyon.
Nice chunk of yardage there on the first play from scrimmage. Pickup of about eight. At quarterback this year for the South Lyon Lions, number 5, Carlo Zarati. He had experience at quarterback last year as well. He's a senior this year. Zarati takes the snap. Looks like it may be a broken play. He does have the capability to scramble. He's able to get close to the line of scrimmage. Small loss on the play will bring up third and about 2.5, maybe 3. And Lyons will face a third and short for the first time this season at their own 27-yard line. Just under 11.5 to go here in the first quarter. Just underway at the beautiful Pinckney High School. Give up the middle, and he is met immediately and did not get to the 30 based on my angle. We are on the left side of the press box over here.
Brent was the ball carrier.
And they may measure. It's close. And they actually will not measure. It is a Lion first down. I did not see who was on the carry there. I think it was maybe number 41, Stone Ruffin. That sounds about right. We remember Stone carrying the ball in the between the tackles last year. Play action of Ruffin, now going up top. Zarati's pass, incomplete. Looks like it was intended for either 40, A.J. Bodell, or number 7, Chris Job. Not a bad throw. Might have had a shot at it. Had either of them seen it coming at him. Brings up second and 10.
11 Lasso, depending on the play for the Pirates. Second and 10.
Nope. Oh, Zarati has a snap go over his head. And he's unable to get on it, and the Pirates have it. No doubt about it. And let's see here, number 55 for the Pirates, Ed Buning with a big play. And the Pirates are going to start first and 10 inside the Lion red zone. They'll be at the 16, 10:36 to play in this first quarter. Jack Werzer at quarterback for the Pirates, give up the middle. Not a lot there. Maybe a pickup of one or two.
About a yard and a half, 2 yards on the carry, second down and eight at the 14.
Would like to mention a few things after this play here. Give to number 20, Levi Collins.
Number 20, Collins, again the ball carrier for the Pirates.
He's able to get to the corner for a few yards. He looks like he marked it about the 12-yard line. Bring up third and... No, I'm sorry. That's
third down and six for the Pirates.
Third and six. Jeff Henson taking over as the head coach for South Lyon this year in his first year. Rolling to the near side. Quarterback awfully close to a first down. He's going to have it. Marked at the 4-yard line. Nice play by Jack Werzer. He's not all that tall, listed at 5'9", but has a little bit of that Flutie magic, looks like, with the mobility. So we'd definitely like to welcome Coach Henson to the South Lyon community. He's been here, though, for about the last 7 years, just taking over as head coach this year. And I'd also like to mention we are ecstatic to be back on South Lyon Cable Channel 19 this year after a 2-year hiatus. Flag on the play.
Werzer again gets the ball and is tackled for a loss. And there are penalty flags on the field.
That was Werzer again on the keeper. Penalty was personal foul on South Lyon for a face mask. We'll make it first and goal inside the 5. And we have a stoppage. Timeout Pinckney. That'll be there first. Give to the tailback, number 20, Levi Collins. And the Lion D line ready to go. Good penetration by the front four there to punch him back a little bit. Pinckney knocking on the door. If you're just joining us, Pinckney was able to take advantage of a botched snap out of the shotgun formation after South Lyon had converted a first down and started at the line inside the Lyon 20. Now knocking on the door inside the 10. And we have whistles. Looks like a false start. We'll back Pinckney up 5 yards. Make it second and goal from the 10. Werzer back to pass, fire slant route. Has a man tackled at the 2-yard line. Touchdown saving tackle by number 11, Ethan Covert. We'll make it third and goal from about the 2-yard line, it looked like.
Covert on that tackle for South Lyon. The ball at the 1.5-yard line.
Defense could really make a statement here now. 7:35 and counting to play first quarter. On their heels. Pinckney out of the gun. Man in motion. Give to the tailback. Touchdown, Pirates. Number 20, Levi Collins. Punches it in. That'll give the home crowd something to cheer about here with 7:23 to play in the first quarter, and the Pinckney Pirates go up 6-0. Number 30, Riley Alexander on for the extra point. And if he gets into one like he did the kickoff, this should be a walk in the park for the young man. See here, he is a senior. Kick is up, and it looks good. So the Pirates will lead at 7-0, 7:23 remaining in the first quarter. We'll be back in a moment. Alexander with the boot, and again will be a touchback.
Kickoff out of the end zone.
Lions will start first and 10 at their own 20 again. They were able to convert a first down last time and then turn the ball over on a botched snap, which resulted in the Pinckney touchdown. This is the Lions' second possession here. It is week one. There's going to be some jitters. We didn't get a chance to do a really true pregame show, and that's something I usually like to talk about in week one is special teams and turnovers and penalties. Although they're important every week, it seems like in week one they really can rear their ugly heads or they can win you a football game. And based on what I've seen from the Pirates so far with their kicker and the offense taking advantage of a turnover, Lions are going to need to pick it up. Nice play there, number nine on the reception, Josh Travis. Should be enough for a first down. It is to the 31-yard line. 6:45 to play in this first quarter. The Pirates leading it 7-0 on August 25th, 2016. I'm Dan Pelchett alongside Matt Boyer on camera. This KLS-TV.com presentation. Give off the right side to number 24, Will Kelly, the junior. Listed at 5'11", 190. Looks like he moves pretty well. He's gashed the Pirate defense on a couple of carries for 6 and 7 yards here early. Tell you what, the boys on the field probably aren't hating the shade from the woods around this field, getting on the covering a majority of the football field because it is very humid for the 80-degree temperature. Balls away from Zarate. Complete if he got a foot in, and he did. Great catch by number 9, Josh Travis, and the Lions sparked to life after that big play. Pick up of about 30 on the play. Lines out of the gun. Three wide, man in motion. Give to the motion man, 24. He's got some room. Again, that is Will Kelly. And I'll tell you what, and I didn't get a chance to mention this earlier, freshman and JV games yesterday, high-scoring affairs. In the freshman game, we had darn near 80 points, and the JV team in the second game, although there was a small monsoon rolling through, ended up hanging up about 36, 37 points as well. Both teams won for South Lyon. So the varsity team in here looking for the sweep tonight. Zarate with the option pitch to 25. And wouldn't you know it, I don't have a 25 on here. Flag is down. That's going to be a hold on the Lions. Oh, boy.
Holy penalty against South Lyon. Throws the ball back to the 35-yard line.
5:11 remaining in this first quarter. Lions trail the Pinckney Pirates 7-0 on a 2-yard touchdown run from number 20, Levi Collins, for the Pirates. Zarate with the give to 25, and again, I will find out who 25 is. I do not have him on my roster. Small gain on the play, going to make it third down in a long 13. Michael Martinez is listed as the Lions kicker. He is a senior. Of course, Vince Candela graduating last year was always steady at the kicks, but this is not in anyone's range right here. Zarate, middle screen, sets it up nicely. Nice open field tackle by number 9, Dolan Meineke. Or else that could have been a huge play for South Lyon. but maybe that was enough to get him into field goal range. You're looking at about a 40-yarder, which is not a chip shot. 23 is coming on the field. That is the kicker, Michael Martinez. 3:50 and counting to play in this first quarter. Maher on to hold. Here we go. Snap is down, kick is up, and it just shy. So Pinckney will take over after the missed field goal at their own 23-yard line. They lead it 7-0 with 3:29 to play in the first quarter. Gashing run up the middle for the Pirates. Pickup of about 15. Will be a first down out to their 34-yard line.
Ball carrier for the Pirates is number 20, Levi Collins. Picks up the first down for the Pirates. Blackwell on the tackle for South Lyon.
Werzer with the give. Again to number 20. Levi Collins picks up about 9.
Collins following a good blocking up front. Gets the ball up to 40.
Well, might be closer to 8.
2 yard line. Michael Maher on the tackle, number 6 for South Lyon.
Number 6, Mike Maher on the tackle for South Lyon.
Second and 2.
Pass complete to number 4, Wes Smith. And
number 4, Wes Smith.
Coach Henson mentioned earlier this week that the tight end game was something Pinckney had been working on. Nice fake on the read option, sold it well, and the tight end had some room. Makes it first and 10 inside the line, 40 to the 39, approaching the 2-minute mark here of the first quarter. Give up the middle, tripped over his own feet there, number 10, Luke Rendell. And we have a timeout on the field. South Lyon, that is their first, and we'll take a break with them. Quarterback going to keep it on the option, has some room off the left side, has a first down and more. Finally ushered out of bounds at about the Lions 16-yard line. And the defense for South Lyon is having a hard time coming up with answers for really just about anything Pinckney's throwing at him, whether it be the tight end or the tailback, number 20, Levi Collins. And don't forget about Doug Flutie looking like Jack Werzer out there at 5'9", number 5 at quarterback. Looks like there must have been a flag on the play. Just 1:36 left here in the first quarter. First and 10 for Pinckney at the South Lyon 16. Passes away, complete. On the back shoulder throw to number 11, Alex Wassel. He's got a first down, making it first and goal at the Lyon 5. Defense in a tough spot here with Pinckney already showing so many options to go to on offense. Close to the pylon on the far side. Touchdown, Pinckney. Levi Collins. His second of the day. This one from 5 yards out will make it 13-0 for the home team. And Riley Alexander on for the extra point can make this a 14-point game with 1:08 remaining in the first quarter.
Alexander on the extra point again.
Kick is up and it is good. 14-0. The Pinckney Pirates lead it with 1:08 to play in the first. Give to 24, Will Kelly. Stretched out pretty good, not much doing. Roddy back to pass. Intercepted, number 21, Nick Kane. An incredible catch by the defensive back. And he's got some room on the far left side. Zarati able to make a tackle, but not until Pinckney will be back inside South Lyon territory at the 40-yard line with 19 seconds remaining in this first quarter. Pinckney going right for the dagger. Pass intended for Dolan Meineke. Number 11, Ethan Covert in coverage for the Lions. 15 seconds left in this first quarter and it can't end quick enough for the Lions to get a fresh start here, hopefully in the second. They trail 14-0 to the Pinckney Pirates. Lions get into the backfield. There is a flag on the play. Carry by Levi Collins, who has two touchdowns on the day for the Pirates. Let's see what the call is.
No gain on the carry.
Pass complete. Pickup of about 10, awfully close to a first down. Definitely close enough to consider going for it, up 14. Just underway here in the second quarter. Pinckney driving after a South Lyon interception. Fourth and a long one here. And we're going to get a timeout on the field. Nope, a flag down. Well, this might shake up the coaching decision here. If it happens to be on the Pirates. They're waving it off, so we're going to go back at it again. Fourth down and just a little over a yard. They got to get to the, looks like the backside of the 30-yard line from here. And now we're going to get a timeout on the field. Pinckney, that's their second. We'll take a break with them. Quarterback keeper going to be awfully close. Looks like he's going to get the spot from the near official at least. He needed to get to just the backside of the 30-yard line. First down, Pirates on the keeper by Jack Werzer. Oh, buddy, and the Lions are defense on their heels here again. Lots of time left in this one, just early here, just about a minute into this second quarter, but they are down 14 on two early touchdowns from Levi Collins, the junior tailback, number 24 on the carry here. Max Bachmeyer, flag and a couple flags. As things might be getting a little chippy down there. Flags were on the defense. South Lyon hit with a personal foul penalty. It'll be first and 10 now at the Lyon 15. Under pressure, buys time, and he'll be sacked.
Orders are on the carry, tackled by 24, Kelly.
Will Kelly in on the sack as Werzer just ran out of room and time. Big play for the Lion defense to push him back there after the personal foul penalty. Makes it second down in about, and we'll say, we'll call it 18.
It'll be second down and 18 for the Pirates.
Whistles on the field and a flag from the back official in the end zone, and it is on the Pirates. That'll back him up another five, makes it second down and 23. And the Pirates helping the Lion defense out after the personal foul call. Back to pass out of the gun. Werzer under pressure, sack lunch, 32. Travis Marcus on the play. And the defense answers here, forcing a third down and a long way. They got to get to the five for a first, and they're at the 40, so third down and 35. Pinckney out of the gun, back to passes. Werzer steps up to buy some time under pressure and brought down short of the line of scrimmage again. Makes it fourth down and long. Had a hard time seeing who got in on that tackle on the far sideline there. Punt team comes on for the Pirates with 8:16 and counting to play in this second quarter. Lions defense able to what appears like dodge a bullet after the Pirates had it first and 10 at the Lion 15 just three short downs ago. Nice kick in, checks it up. Looks like it'll be down about the 14-yard line. And South Lyon will start first and 10 there, 7:49 left to play in this second quarter. The Pirates lead South Lyon Lions 14 to nothing. Give is to 21, LC Morgan. He's able to pick up a nice gain there on first down, about... pickup of about six.
Second down and four.
Twins to the right side for the Lions out of the gun. Option read given to 25. Who I've been told is Ryan Gill. And we have an injury on the play. Third and less than a yard here for South Lyon after the injury timeout. Give up the middle. He's able to fight his way for about three or four. Most importantly, a Lyon first down.
And first down.
Lions going with a little bit of a quicker pace here. Will Kelly in motion for the Lions. Give to the back as a lane takes a shot. 36, Ben Buckler with a nice carry though. Pickup of about 9. And we got a stop on the field. Oh, they're gonna take a look and see if they need to measure. And they will. After the measurement, South Lyon ends up with a first down at their own 38-yard line. Back to pass, Zarati finds a man. It's Kelly who's able to touch drill his way to midfield. Great effort. Clock will run. Now that the chains are set, we're under 6 minutes, about 5:45 and counting in this second quarter. Give to the tailback, it's 36. Ben Buckler again. Pickup of about 4.
Ben Buckler on the carry. Yeah, second down and 5.
Pinckney front 4 able to penetrate there and snuff that out.
South Lyon running back met by Oster Pirates. 41
checks in for South Lyon, Stone Ruffin.
Bring up a third down and 7 now for South Lyon. They're at the 47 yard line.
Zarati gonna keep it on the option. Now goes late to Ruffin. It's gonna make it fourth down. Minimal gain on that play. Maybe a yard. 4:20 and counting to play in the second quarter. Lions trail the Pirates 14-0. In the season opener here at Pinckney High School on August 25th, 2016. I'm Dan Pelchett alongside Matt Boyer on camera. We thank you very much for joining us in the season opener and the return of high school football. Lyon's gonna go for it. Zarati checks it down and gonna run for it. I think he got it with the dive, and he did. Just enough as he got to the sideline. Will be first and 10 South Lyon at the Pirate 40. Clock will stop with 3:50 remaining in the first half.
But it is a first down for South Lyon at the Pinckney 40.
Ruffin up the middle, fights his way for about 3 or 4.
Ruffin on the carry for the Lions. Tackle there by Henry. He has second down and 6. 6.5.
Zarati gives to Ruffin. He lost his footing. There is a flag on the far side.
No game, but there is a penalty flag on the field.
Pirates' initial reaction looks like it is going to be against South Lyon, and they want to push him back.
It's a holding penalty against South Lyon. moves the ball back to the 50-yard line.
Clock will run. Second down and 20 from midfield for South Lyon. Desperately trying to get something on the board here before the end of the half. Play action goes up top, has a man, just overshot him. 21, LC Morgan, the intended receiver. We'll make it third down and 20 from the 50-yard line. 2:50 remaining first half. Timeout, South Lyon, their second. Zarati under pressure, trying to buy time, does, fires, incomplete. Intended for 24, Will Kelly. Brings up fourth down and 20 for midfield in a punting situation, but there is a flag back behind the play. Looks like it is a holding call against South Lyon. It'll be declined, and the Lions will have to punt with 2:40 remaining in the second quarter. Deep to return for the Pirates, number 11, Alex Wasil, and number 9, Dolan Meineke. 24, Will Kelly on to punt for South Lyon. Hangs it up there, Butte. Fair catch called and made at the 15-yard line. Give up the middle, not much there. Second and 11 for the Pirates now. Lions defense would love to cause a turnover here. Try and get something going before the half. Pinckney may be content with just going to the locker room, leading up 14 to nothing. Give to number 10. Nice stick on the far side. Luke Rendell on the carry. And we got a timeout on the field. Timeout charge to South Lyon. That is their last. So with 1:41 left in the second quarter, Lions are trying to get a stop and force a punt. Big third down here. Pinckney, twins to the near side, out of the gun. Quarterback gonna keep it on the option read. Picks up a few to get across the 20 to the 21. Will force a fourth down. But the Lions are out of timeouts, but Pinckney will be forced to punt. Let's see if the Lions come after this. Should have about 45 seconds left. LC Morgan deep to return for the Lions. Lions come after it. Oh, gets it away. Fair catch called and he muffs it. Scooped up by the Pirates. They can't advance it. But they will have it first and 10 at the Lion 40. And the only thing positive that came out of that is there is a flag down. As the clock continued to run for about 5 seconds after the Pirates recovered it. Let's see what the call on the field will be here. This could end up being catastrophic for the Lions if the Pirates are able to add to this lead before the half. Officials are talking it over. Looks like the flag could involve possibly fair catch interference. So after a discussion on the field, it was kick catch interference. The Lions will have it first and 10 at the Pinckney 37. They are out of timeouts. 41 seconds left in the second quarter. They trail the Pirates by 14. Huge opportunity here to get back in it. But the Lions will have to be very aware of the clock. And now that 5 seconds that ran off actually hurts us instead of helping us. Zerati back to pass, fires, has a man, steps out of bounds. Gain of 6, number 40, A.J. Bodell with the reception. Yeah, it looks like they end up marking about a gain of 5. 37 seconds left on the clock.
We have about 4.
Lions came up just short from about 40 yards earlier on a field goal attempt in the first quarter. Zerati again back to pass, has to get rid of it, incomplete. 32 seconds remaining now. Third down, a long 5. Zerati out of the pistol, actually keeps it, and he's sacked back at the 40, and that's huge because the clock will continue to run, and now it's fourth down. Maybe they can just heave one up to the end zone and either hope for a penalty or a catch because you can't clock it. Nobody knows what's going on as the clock continues to run. And I don't even know what to say about that. So we'll head to the half. Your score, the Pinckney Pirates 14, the South Lyon Lions 0. As we head to the half, we'll be back with a second half here from Pinckney High School after this. And we welcome you back to Pinckney High School, the start of the third quarter just underway, where the Pinckney Pirates have opened up a 14-point lead on the visiting South Lyon Lions.
Number 9, Dylan Meineke.
Kick returned to about the 26-yard line, where the Pirates' offense will start. Lions defense have their work cut out for them, stopping the work of number 20 at tailback Levi Collins. Number 5, Jack Werzer, were very effective in the first half. Collins with 2 touchdown runs, 1 of 2 yards, 1 of 5, and that's the difference right now. Lions did have an opportunity at a long field goal in the first quarter. They missed from about 40 yards out, came up just short. It was a good kick, had everything but the distance. So let's see if the Lions can turn a page here after the halftime and forget about that first half. Werzer back to pass, fires, dropped. And it looks like 36 there. Ben Buckler to deliver a hit on the wide receiver. Brings up 2nd and 10. I would consider this a pretty big possession here. If the Lions could force a 3-and-out, get a little momentum going, you know, in favor of the offense, help them out with some field position too, possibly. Although the Pirate kicking game has been on par so far, whether it be punting or extra points or kickoffs, pretty solid all the way around. Here's the tailback, 20, Levi Collins, stopped for a loss as he tried to get outside on the far sideline. Line defense appears to be fired up and ready to go here. Brings up a third and long situation, about third and 14, maybe 13, at the Pinckney 24-yard line. Thank you very much for joining us. I'm Dan Pelchat on play-by-play. The best cameraman in the KLAA, Matt Boyer, on camera here at the beautiful Pinckney High School. Rolling out, throws it down. That could be intentional grounding, and it is. And that's a big penalty because it's a loss of down. That'll move them back, and it'll be fourth down. So they'll be punting from deep inside their own end. Say the shadows of their own goalposts, but as the sun is setting on what has been a beautiful Thursday evening here in Southeast Michigan. Game time kickoff temperature was about 80 degrees. It's probably dropped at least 10 or so since then here on August 25th, 2016, as they walk off the intentional grounding. Makes it fourth down and, 24. Looks like number 9 on the punt, Dolan Meineke. Ooh, nearly got there. Lions have been coming after it a little bit. Nice punt away from the return man. Fielded at the 45 and the ball's out. Lions able to hop on it. Number 11, Ethan Covert there. 10.5 left to play in this third quarter. Lions trail 14-0. They'll start their first drive of the second half at their own 46-yard line. Zerati takes the snap. Ball's on the ground. Looks like the Lions were able to hop back on it, though. Loss of 3 on the play. Just about 2 minutes into this third quarter at Pinckney High School. Lions trail 14-0. Zerati back to pass, fires, complete, and his knee was down. I believe that's 9, Josh Travis. Nice play there on second down to make it third and manageable after the botched handoff on first down. Kind of opens the playbook for South Lyon.
Third down and about 3.
Zerati's got 36. Ben Buckler behind him in the pistol. Trips to the near side. Buckler takes it and is eaten up at the line of scrimmage, if that. And it's decision time for the Lions. Looks like the punt team will come on. With 9 minutes and counting to play in this third quarter, Lions wisely will play the field position game. Defense forced a 3-and-out to open the second half. And they'll look to do the same. Oh, Lions thinking about it. Pinckney was ready for the fake punt. 24, Will Kelly. May have been one of those options where, you know, you can punt it or run it, and the Pirates were ready for it. 8:28 to play third quarter. Pinckney will take over at the Lion 49-yard line. Flag down. Looks like a false. Oh, nope, delay game. Back them up 5. Back in to Pirate territory at their own 46. Make it first and 15. Good stop in the backfield there by number 10, Ryan Peterson. Makes it second down and long now. About 17. Pirates have to get to the Lion 39 for a first down. Quarterback rolls to the far side and picks up about six before he's forced out of bounds. That was Jack Werzer. Werzer gets across the line of scrimmage, a pickup of about two, brings up fourth down and eight. Three or seven and a half to go here in the third quarter. Punting situation for the Pirates. Another nice defensive stand by the Lion defense. Deep to return for the Lions, number nine. Josh Travis, the 6'4 senior wide receiver. Kick is away, it's a beaut. Travis calls for a fair catch and gets it at about the 15 yard line. 6:51 to play, third quarter. Lions trail 14 to nothing. Zerati, play action pass, going for Travis. Caught inside Pinckney territory. A huge play for this Lion offense just when they needed it. Pickup of about 35 on the play. First and 10 South Lyon now inside Pinckney territory. 6:44 to play, third quarter. Offense still looking for their first points, trailing 14 to nothing. Zerati back to pass again, has a man wide open down the seam and just overshot him. Cliff Price. Oh, Nelly. Carlo wishing he had another shot at that one. Makes it second down and 10 at the Pinckney 47. Passes away, complete to number 7, Chris Job, making a nice catch there with some pretty good coverage on him. Gonna be a couple yards shy of a first down, but third and manageable. Third and about two. As we approach the 6 minute mark of the third quarter. Option to the near side, stopped immediately. Buckler on the carry. Gonna force a fourth down and official timeout on the field. Big fourth down here for the Lions. Looking at about, gonna need 4.5 on this fourth and four. Ruffin to Zerati's right. Zerati back to pass, fires. Comeback route is going to be intercepted on the near sideline. Looked like 21. Nick Kane, his second of the game. And looked like he knew the route. Pinckney will take over. First and 10 at their own 35-yard line with 5:12 remaining in the third quarter. They lead it 14 to nothing. Broken play. Words are going to keep it. Tiptoes down the sideline. He'll be picking up about 9 on the play. Close to a first down. Knew it was a broken play, committed to it, and just got what he could. Very impressed with the quarterback play, the junior, Jack Werzer, for the Pirates. Give is to 24, Max Bachmeyer. Maybe a half a yard there. Make it third and inches. 4:45 and counting to play third quarter. Pirates leading in the season opener, 14 to nothing. On a pair of touchdowns for number 20, Levi Collins. Stretches it out, and he's got some room. Turns the corner across the 40 and knocked out of bounds by number 3, Braxton Blackwell. That was Bachmeyer again on the carry for the Pirates into Lion territory. Be first and 10, Pinckney at the line 36.
Blackwell, number 3 on the tackle for the top line. Let's play tight. Follows at the South Lyon 36 yard line. First and 10, Pirates.
Tie came on, nobody came off. He's off.
Nice play in the backfield there by number 10, Ryan Peterson. Trying to rally this defense after giving up a gasher for a first down on a third and short on the previous play.
Second down and 12.
Play action pass has a man open down the seam, complete inside the 10. Number 11, Alex Wassel. That'll be first and 10 at the line 11, 3:38 to play third quarter. And the Pirates knocking on the door again. Can the Lions defense stand up? Give up the middle, and that's going to be a hat trick for number 20, Levi Collins. He'll add an 11-yard touchdown run to his pair in the first half, making it 20 to nothing with 3:19 to play third quarter with the extra point to follow. Riley Alexander on for the point after. What little wind we did have has died down here now. Kick is up and it doesn't get prettier than that. Right down the pipe. Your score, the Pinckney Pirates 21, the South Lyon Lions 0, 3:19 to play third quarter. Kick is away. And it'll be a touchback, his third of the day for Riley Alexander. Lions will start first and 10 at their own 20. looking to get something going here late in the third. Zerati back to pass, sets up the middle screen, he's got it. Ryan Gill with the completion, he's gonna try and bounce it back to the near side. Pickup of about 15 will stop the clock at 3:09 left to play in the third, and a first down for South Lyon at their own 35-yard line. Give to the man in motion, number 21, Elsie Morgan. Tackled for a loss of 5 on the play. Zerati out of the pistol. Give to the tailback. We'll get close to the original line of scrimmage. Should be about 3rd and 11. Zerati, play action, fires, intercepted off the deflection. Pinckney will have it first, and it's who else but 21, Nick Kane, his third interception of the game. Pinckney will have it first and 10 at the Lion 30 with a minute 26 to play in the third. Give to the tailback, 24, Bachmeyer. Stop for a loss on the play. Looked like 32, Travis Marcus. And 10, Ryan Peterson in on the stop. Loss of 3 on the play. I'll make it 2nd and 13 as we are under a minute to go now in this third quarter, where the Pirates lead it 21-0. They've been able to take advantage of South Lyon's turnovers. Backed up pass, fires over the middle. A great catch by Kane. And putting to sleep all those stereotypes about defensive backs not being able to catch. That was a stab there. He's also listed as a wide receiver, of course, but the young man has 3 interceptions on the other side of the ball. 3rd down and 4 as we're under 20 seconds to play now in this third quarter. We'll see if they decide to run a play or not. They will have to. No, they will not. That will do it. So we'll take a break. Your score after 3 quarters of play at Pinckney High School. The Pirates of Pinckney lead it 21-0 over your Lions of South Lyon. We'll be back with the fourth quarter in a moment. Big 3rd down play and picks it up. Down to the Lion 15. Number 24, Max Bachmeyer again, part of that stable of running backs we've seen today from the Pinckney Pirates, the two of them, 24 and 20. Levi Collins with the 3 touchdowns, but Bachmeyer's been effective too. With a big third down conversion there. Pass knocked down, and that's the one thing you might see about Jack Werzer that he can't do much about. If a lineman comes clean and gets his hands up, the 5'9 youngster isn't going to be able to throw over the top of him. But he sure as heck can occasionally run away from him, as he's had himself a game here tonight. We are just underway here in the fourth quarter. Pinckney back inside the Lion red zone with a chance to really blow this thing open, up 21-0 already. Werzer gonna run with it. He'll be brought down.
Werzer on the sweep, gets knocked out of bounds.
Maybe a gain of two, depending on the spot. Not even. Gonna be third down, and we're gonna get a timeout on the field. Now we're good. Third and nine from the Lion 15. Collins running hard. Nice tackle by a pair of Lions there. Looked like number three, Braxton Blackwell, number 55, Sanji Britton. Makes it fourth down, and the Pirates will send down the field goal unit.
Blackwell, tackle for
number 30, Riley Alexander. Will attempt a 29-yard field goal from the right hash. There is not an ounce of wind anymore. Young man has shown plenty of leg throughout this game so far. Kick is up, and it is good. So the Pirates will add to their lead, but the defense is able to keep it to a three-possession game. 24-0, Pinckney leads it with 10:31 to play in the fourth quarter. Cerati out of the gun. Play action fires, just too much. And that's a fourth interception for Nick Cade. And that is gonna be taken inside the five, nearly a touchdown. But Zarati was able to get over there and knock him out of bounds. A prideful effort there by number five at quarterback, and I can appreciate that. You're not gonna coast into the end zone on your fourth interception on Carlo Zarati. 10:22 left to play in the fourth quarter. Pinckney leads it 24-0. Give to Bachmeyer, and if he didn't get in, he's awfully close. Good decision on the Pinckney Pirate coaching staff to let someone else try and get in there. We got a Lion down on the play, it looks like. Injury timeout on the field. We'll step out for a moment as well. Under center, goes with the quarterback keep. I don't know if he got in there. Werzer tried to fight his way through. We'll make it third down and goal from inside the one. Werzer out of the gun. Man in motion. Werzer gonna keep it on the quarterback. Sneaks it in for the touchdown. And with 9 minutes left to play in the fourth quarter, the Pirates will go up 30-0 on South Lyon with the extra point to follow.
Yeah.
Alexander's extra point is good. Your score, 31 for the Pinckney Pirates and South Lyon, 0. Kick is away and into the end zone for a touchback.
Kickoff by Alexander.
Lions will start at their own 20. 9 minutes left to play in the fourth. Give to the tailback. Looks like 25.
No gain on that carry by the Lions. The second down and 10. Chapman and Price combining on that last tackle for the Pirates.
Second and 10 for South Lyon is the offense looks to get something going. They'll fumble the ball again, and it looks like the Pirates will have it around the 21-yard line.
Fumble off the field. Recovered by the Pirates.
Looks like 21 Nick Kane in at quarterback now for Pinckney. As the Lions will be looking to just finish strong here for some pride and improve towards next week as they trail by 31 and Pinckney having it first and 10 inside the 20. Here in the fourth quarter, 7:50 to go. I'm Dan Pelchett alongside Matt Boyer on camera. We thank you very much for joining us in this week one matchup out at Pinckney High School of the high school football season in 2016. Nice tackle by number 41, Stone Ruffin. Makes it third and 12. Now Lions just, story of the day, just couldn't get going on offense and a dozen turnovers is, you're never gonna win. And then the opportunities that they did have, had a possibility on a seam route down the middle earlier. Carry off the left side by number 10, Luke Rendell, stopped around the line of scrimmage. And really, you can cliff note it in one simple stat, the 6 turnovers, you're not gonna win a football game, so. Look to get better next week as they'll welcome in the Howell Highlanders. Former KVC rival. Howell was leading Lansing Everett at the half earlier, 9-0. A 38-yard field goal from the left hash from Riley Alexander. Kick is up and it's got plenty of leg and it is good. So with 6:16 left to play in the fourth quarter, the Pinckney Pirates lead it 34-0 over the South Lyon Lions. Kick is away. Takes a odd hop there. Fielded by number 6, Michael Maher. Brought down at about the 19-yard line. That's where the Lion offense will start it back up with 6:09 to play in the fourth. They trail 34-0. Zerati back to pass. Looks like he's setting up the screen. Finds 36 balls on the ground. Scooped up by 62. That's Tyler Longstreet. Nice heads-up play by the big man. The 6'1". 200 senior lineman. That's a story he'll have. Picked up a rushing yard on a fumble. Zerati. Give to the tailback, 36. Buckler. will be close to a first down. 5:40 and counting to play in this fourth quarter.
Mike Mantel on that tackle for the Pirates.
Out route to 24. Will Kelly, he'll have a first down. Up to the 46 of South Lyon. 5:18 left as the clock will stop. So Roddy gonna keep it on the quarterback option. He's across midfield to about the 47 of the Pirates. Second and seven. Zerati, play action. Puts one up. Incomplete. Covered by number 34, Trevor Sork. We'll make it third and three. Zerati out of the gun. End around and then the reverse to 24. Will Kelly is going to have a first down across the 40 to about the 36 with 4:27 to play in the fourth quarter. Lions trailing 34 to nothing here at Pinckney High School. Zerati on the option pitch. Trying to bounce it outside. Number 25, he'll be pushed out of bounds. And the flag for some extracurriculars on the near sideline. 4:19 remaining here in the fourth quarter as things get a little chippy down there. Zerati back to pass, fires, goes up and makes a great catch. Number 7, Chris Jobb, will get the Lions down inside the red zone, down to about the 11-yard line. 4:11 left in this fourth quarter. South Lyon just trying to finish strong here. They trail 34 to nothing. Zerati to the near corner, incomplete. Great coverage by number 3, Jared Hess. Intended for number 9, Josh Travis. Handoff up the middle, fighting his way down inside the five to the two. Actually, more the three. Looked like number six, Michael Maher.
Third down two, for South
Lyon. And Turf Monster gets him. 36 on the carry. Buckler. And a flag. Just losing a little bit of that discipline here as this one gets away from the Lions tonight. Number 10 in at quarterback now for the Pirates, Luke Randall. And they're just here to get some kids in, some playing time that haven't yet, and run this clock out on the Lions. The Pirates will improve to 1-0. And as they'll play their final year in the KLAA West, and they'll need every win they can get for their playoff aspirations, because the KLAA West is a no easy task with the Brighton and Howell and Grand Blanks of the world to go on and play. As we approach the 2 minute mark here, makes it third down now and 11. Give up the middle. Looks like Ruffin and crew in on the tackle. Brings up fourth down and about 10 at the original line of scrimmage, about minute 27 and counting. And the punt team will come on for the Pirates. Will Kelly at quarterback for South Lyon. Gives to the tailback, Ruffin. Tackle made at about the 17-yard line with about 30 seconds left in this one. This should be the final play of the ball game as we have 12 seconds and counting. Low snap, fakes the Ruffin. And the Lions are gonna score on the final play of the game. Number 24, Will Kelly, takes it in from 18 yards out to put the Lions on the board, 34-6. Now, the Lions may have to kick this extra point. They may not, I don't know. Doesn't look like it. So that'll do it here from Pinckney High School. For Dan Pelchett, I'm Matt Boyer on camera. Stick around, we'll do a quick post-game show. No, we're not gonna do a post-game show. So once again, I'm Dan Pelchett. Thanks for tuning in. Matt Boyer on camera. Your final score from Pinckney High School, the Pinckney Pirates 34, the South Lyon Lions 6. We'll see you next week, folks, next Thursday at the Jungle as Howell comes to town. Remember, it's a great day to be living in America. We'll see you next week.